Hello everybody, in today's tutorial, you'll learn how to create a flat illustration that has a noise texture applied using Illustrator. The first step is to sketch out your idea or just feel free to use mine. If you want to follow along, you should find a link in the description of this video. You can then place it inside Illustrator, go to the transparency tab and lower it somewhere around 20%, then create a new layer and place it underneath, so whenever you're adding new elements or shapes, they'll be behind the sketch. Start with a circle and only use gray color, so I won't get stuck with trying to get every detail right since this is only the beginning of the process. Using the pen tool, you can start creating elements by tracing underneath the sketch and trying to be as loose as possible. A sketch can only take you so far. Of course, you'll need to do certain adjustments along the way. If you watch any of my previous videos, you also know that I enjoyed the smooth tool, so try going over any paths that have an unnatural look to them. Would also recommend taking the direct selection tool and rounding off some of the sharp corners. Once you're done, you can assign a color to each shape. I found this color scheme on Adobe Color Wheel. You can create your own or use the same one, it's up to you really. Let's apply the red color on the rounded shape. And once that's done, we can move to adding the noise texture. I'll start from the bottom with the shape selected. I'll go to the gradient tab and click on the basic black and white one. Hit G on your keyboard to be able to adjust it. You can then switch it up with a radial gradient from the tab and then go to the effect panel, look for the texture option and select grain. You'll then be presented with a couple of options. Make sure that the selected grain type is stippled and adjust the intensity and the contrast to your liking. Hit OK to see how it looks, and using the gradient tool, I'll slide the colors a bit to get more white in the middle. From the top handle, you can create this oval shape which feels a bit more dynamic. On the handle, you should find the option to rotate it, and on the sides, the handle to make it bigger. We can then go to the transparency tab and select the screen blending mode so that the black noise gets replaced by the color that's behind it. With the black elements, I'm doing the same technique, but I'll use the multiplied blending mode to mask the white noise. For the blue elements, I'll duplicate the shape, then add a gradient on that shape that's above and use the same blending mode. Let's take the red shape for example. I'll first copy and paste it in front in order to duplicate it, add a gradient to it, then add the grain effect. Since I want the white part to be transparent, you guessed it right, I'll use the multiplied blending mode. It's really nice to be able to make adjustments on the fly and see in real time how the illustration looks with the noise texture applied, even though you're actually using the gradient tool. After lowering the opacity on the texture applied on the leg and on the hair, this is the final look of the illustration. Hope you've enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe for more. Till next time, take care everybody. Bye.